Right, now, one of those rules is the Fibonacci series. It's described by Archon Circle, and it's the what's called the golden ratio, 1.618:1. It's an irrational number, that is, you cannot compute it out to zero. Never. And it describes many of the design features of the universe. It was worked out in Fibonacci, in one of the most important texts in the development of mathematics, in 1202. Wow. And that's one page from his book, and that's the series down there, the start of it. It goes on forever. It has so many properties I can't talk to you about them today, and I don't want to make it confusing, so I'm just going to show you a little example. This on the right-hand side is the Whirlpool Galaxy. The Whirlpool Galaxy is designed exactly to the Fibonacci series. So are almost all the galaxies we know. On the left-hand side is Hurricane Isabel. Hurricane Isabel is described by the mathematics of the Fibonacci series. It is one of the very strong numbers in nature. It's one of the things that show us that the whole of the design of the universe is mathematical, is precise, absolutely precise. And one of my old mentors, Richard Feynman, used to say, if the vibration of hydrogen was off by one click a second, the whole universe would wink out. That was Feynman's lecture. So I want you to just consider this in trying to understand the way our body works. We have to understand this. And so we've got it from the stars to the way a weather pattern works. We've got it here again in an ammonite spiral. This is 60 million years old. And it's the same mass that governs us and governs the stars. This is a dragonfly's wing. This is the Fibonacci series of dragonfly's wing. Now, I don't expect you to understand this. By the way, this is a 6-week course. There will be a test. And even a dragonfly's eye is designed to the Fibonacci series. You can compute the eye of a dragonfly. And in similar way, you can compute various parts of a human being. Now, I want to just show you this one little example. This is the cochlea in your ear. Cochleas go way into the head like that. And the cochlea is designed to receive the purest sound, and it's designed to the Fibonacci series. So, if you are wanting to produce the purest sound, what would you do? How would you design something to produce the purest sound? Well, in fact, people have done this. And here is the Stradivarius with some of its ratio. It is designed for the Fibonacci series. And this is Itzhak Perlman playing a Stradivarius with the Israel Philharmonic Orchestra. In a mathematical series. And John understands this. John, when I first went to his lab, I had known of him for 30 years, and I had looked at some things he'd done way, way ago, but I'd never actually met him and gone to his lab. And I went to his lab, and did we talk about all the nutritional thing? We didn't talk one word about nutrition. We talked about asteroids. Because he purchases out asteroids and he pulverizes them and he finds out what their mineral content is and what is the structure of the minerals. There's many what we call isotopic structures in minerals. And that is the way we're made. Now you can't just go out and gather some dirt off the surface of the earth anymore, but the total surface of the earth is contaminated. The total surface by man-made chemicals. So you can't actually take minerals like calcium from the surface of the earth anywhere and find a cure. And so John, as it looked for minerals that were pure, and the very big difference between most of the protein shakes that are produced out there and his is it has minerals in it that are pure. And where did he get them? First of all, he found out what they should be like by pulverizing asteroids and getting a whole structure, isotopic structures. And then he went everywhere looking for them. And he found them in some deep mines, in the humus of million-year-old forests. And he got them out. And that's what goes into the protein shake. They're dug up, and they're pure, they're uncontaminated. I don't know of anybody else in the world that does this, because they don't understand the significance of doing it. They think you can get calcium from a rock, you know, from calcium carbonate, a cliff or something. They don't realize how contaminated that is. And so the protein shakes are very different to what you would get elsewhere. People think, okay, you know, look on the label and they start comparing. I get loads of emails from people that compared one label with another, and they write to me and they say, so-and-so's got this in it, and so-and-so's got that in it. They don't know what they're talking about. If you think that you can find the composition of something by studying labels, you're wrong. Labels are an exercise in concealment, not an exercise in revelation. As soon as the labeling regulations were passed, from the very first day, manufacturers got people to say, okay, how can we write the least thing that is legal? The least or the most confusing thing that is legal? Well, you know about government pronouncements anyway, of any kind. The government actually sets the model. They give you the story that is the most confusing and reveals the least. And that's what the labels do. So when you compare labels, it's a crazy exercise. What you have got to do when you're trying to find out whether a product is any good or not is compare the people that make it. The people that make it. And you know, if their science is not a shining example of science, and if they are not shining examples of what they profess to know, don't believe them. Just don't believe them. Don't do it. Don't buy it. So that's what I wanted to tell you, this because that's the basis of the design of the isolene protein shake. That's where it came from. And John searched the world too for the best protein to put in it. And the reason he wanted to put the best protein in it is because protein, every functioning unit in your body is a protein. All your enzymes are proteins. Your hemoglobin that carries your nutrients in your blood is a protein. All your antibodies are proteins. All the structure of your muscle cells are proteins. All the structure of your brain is of proteins. There are 350,000 different ones. And you and I are made of the proteins that we eat. And if we eat junk proteins, we will grow a junk body. There's no way around it. There's no way of saying, well, you know, this protein, because it comes from a feedlot cow in Arkansas, and it's out in the it's way out in the rural area, is going to be a pure protein. You cannot make a feedlot cow produce good protein. It's impossible, because a cow is a ruminant. A cow has a rumen, which is an acid-neutral fermentation tank for grass. And like a lot of fermentation tanks, it has to be kept going by a constant infusion of grass. That's why ruminants are 24-hour grazers. So you can't take a 24-hour grazer and put it in a feedlot and expect any of its proteins to be any good. That's why feedlot beef is really terrible compared to grass-fed beef. Totally different. I know this a little bit about this. I breed my own cows on Salt Spring Island, on the grass. In fact, my wife was out last night. We couldn't get one of the calves out, and she was out in the field with the vet, and they were doing a cesarean section to save to save the cow last night. When I rang her, she said, I'm out the field doing a cesarean. So, right now, even when you've got the protein like John has got, and take it and put it into to a manufacturer, they have all sorts of their own things. First of all, they have a flavors guy who decides that he can put stuff in there for flavor and mouthfeel and things like that. And then they have a guy who says, well, I've got to have this in it because it's got to slide down the tubes right. And so you get